Hello friends, this is Vedavati Varkala working in Narayana IAS Academy. We have started a new program called Prelims 2020 Made Easy. Today we are going to see a topic from geography called earthquakes. So the waves which are produced when an earthquake happens are called seismic waves. Now these seismic waves are very helpful to know the interior composition of the earth, and we are going to see in that class today. Now what is an earthquake? It is a shaking of earth. In a very layman terms, it is a violent shaking of earth where release of energy happens and waves in all directions. Now that release of energy occurs along a fault. Fault is nothing but a gap between two tectonic blocks. Let me explain all these points with the help of this picture. So the release of the energy, this happens through this fault. This is the fault gap between these two blocks. Now rocks along the fault tend to move in opposite directions. If this moves in this direction, this moves in the opposite direction. Nothing but the displacement of these two rocks. See, because they are moving, this fault is happening, right? But before this, the overlying materials, they exert pressure and they will give some friction for not to move. But in earthquake, because of some highest magnitude, at one point the tendency to move will be very much higher than the friction to hold together. Now when that tendency is more than the friction, these two blocks move in opposite direction and a fault is formed. And this is all because of endogenic process, which means the reasons are coming from inside of the earth. Now why are these moving? There is so much of release of energy and this energy is traveling in all directions. Now when an earthquake happens, the point where the energy is released is called the focus of an earthquake. Now this is the point where the energy is released. This point focus is also called as hypocenter. Now the point which is nearest to the focus but on the surface of the earth is called as epicenter. See, this point is epicenter. This point is on the surface, right? Now this is the first point to experience the earthquake waves and it spreads in all directions. Now these are the two important points that we need to remember about epicenter. It is always on the surface and is directly above the focus. Now let us see what are the type of earthquake waves. See, the instrument which records earthquake waves is known as seismograph. It is placed in different directions. So when an earthquake happens, this instrument records them. Now all the natural earthquakes are happened in the first 200 kilometers from the earth's surface. See, what is the first 200 kilometers? It is nothing but the lithosphere, which is crust plus upper mantle. Here seismic waves are divided into two types, body waves and surface waves. Here body waves is very important for us to learn, because from these waves only we get to learn what is the interior of the earth. So the body waves are again divided into primary waves and secondary waves, or else P waves or S waves. Before we see how they explain the interior structure, we need to remember some basic points about P waves and S waves. These waves move in all directions, traveling throughout the body of the earth. See, in this picture, they are traveling throughout the body and in all the directions. Next point, velocity of waves changes as they travel through different materials with different densities. He means to say that we have three layers, right? Crust, mantle and core. So this is the lighter one, this is the heavier one, and this is much heavier one, right? So when the waves are passing through this, they will have different velocities in different zones. And they say denser the material, higher is the velocity. They mean to say that the speed in core is very much higher than in mantle and than in crust. And it is not just velocity that is changing. Even the direction also changes according to the densities. So if it is passing straight in crust, it might get refracted a little in mantle and might get refracted more in core, because there is difference in densities. Now we will see the basic difference between P waves and S waves, and then we see how are they passing through the earth and how are they telling us the interior. See, P waves are also called as primary waves. S waves are also called as secondary waves. P waves, they come faster and the first to arrive at the surface. And after P waves arrive, after some time, then comes the S waves. Now, what is the specialty of P waves is they are just like sound waves, which means they can travel through all the mediums, solids, liquids and gases. But there is a limitation to S waves. They can travel only through solids. Now, this is the very important differentiation. From this only, we get to know the interior structure of the earth. Now, another important differentiation is P waves travel parallel to the direction of the wave. If the direction of wave is like this, P waves also generate in this direction only. But in S waves, the direction is perpendicular to the wave direction. Now, P waves are passing parallelly, they exert pressure in this direction only on the materials, while S waves exert direction in a vertical manner because they travel perpendicular. Now, P waves can create density differences, and as they are traveling parallelly, they lead to stretching and squeezing, but in the same direction. But in S waves, they create crest and troughs. Now, this is much more destructive than the P waves. See, these waves are more destructive and they cause displacement of rocks and even the collapse of structures also. Here in P waves, it's just the fault that is happening, much more of stretching and squeezing only. But here, because the formation of crest and troughs, it is almost forming the collapse of structures. Now let us see a concept called shadow zone, which helps us to know the interior of the earth. See, what have we discussed? That earthquake waves get recorded in seismographs, right? These are the instrument which are placed in different locations on the surface of the earth. They are located in far off locations, and they found that in some zones waves are getting recorded and in some zones they are not reported. And the zones in which the waves are not reported are known as shadow zone. And what is that zone? It is the zone between 105 degrees and 145 degrees from epicenter. What is epicenter? It is the point exactly above focus on the surface of the earth. We discussed, right, epicenter is the point which is the first to experience the earthquake waves. So let me explain this with the help of the diagram. See, here is the epicenter, and the zone between 105 degrees and 145 is the shadow zone. Now this is for P wave. In here, the waves could not be reported, but we can see some direct P waves here. And why is this happening? See, in the first we discussed, right, when P waves and S waves, they go through different densities, they change their velocities and they change their directions. So here imagine this is the mantle, P waves are passing like this. But here, as soon as they encountered the core region, because core is comparatively denser than the mantle, see, the direction has changed like this. The waves got deflected. And they also observed that the velocity in the core is much more than the velocity in the mantle. Why? We discussed, right, whenever they encounter a denser medium, their velocity increases. So, the wave direction was like this until the core. So, as soon as they are coming out of the core again their direction changed because they encountered the mantle again and their velocity decreased because mantle is less denser than core. Now, they saw S wave zone now. See, up to 105 degrees, everything was fine like P waves only. But after 105, they could not see any more S waves. But in P wave, after 145, there were waves here, right? But in S waves, there are no direct waves. And why is this? What did we discuss about S waves? They can travel only through solids, right? So up to here, everything was fine with S waves. But here, they could not enter into this region. So by this, what can we say? That there is some liquid region here, and that's why S waves could not pass into this. If everything was solid here, S waves could have passed just like the P waves only. P waves can pass through solids, liquids and gases, right? So it had no problem. It could pass through solids and also the liquid region here. But S waves could not pass, right? So they were absent in this region and their shadow region is much more higher than the P waves. And because of this phenomena only, we tend to understand that there is some liquid region here and that is outer core. But how did we know that the inner core is solid? See, we came to know this is liquid because S wave could not pass. How did we know that this is solid? Now let's come back to P wave zone again. See, here let us imagine that the P waves are traveling with some velocity. Now when they entered from mantle to core, the velocity changed. The velocity increased because core is the denser medium than mantle. And just now we understood that this is all liquid. When they entered to the core center of the earth, their velocity was much more higher than in mantle and than in outer core. See, what did we discuss about these waves? That when a much denser medium comes, their velocity increases. Here, if the velocity is the highest, it means that this is much more denser medium than anything out there. So, from this people understood that there must be some very solid and dense zone. That's why P waves are traveling with so much speed. So, from this we understood that there is some solid region here. So, in crux, by the absence of S waves, we understood that the outer core is liquid, and from the velocity of P waves, we understood that the inner core is solid. And that's how we came to know about the interior composition of the earth.